All right, hello everyone, and welcome back to Kerbal Space Program, where today we are having a look at the Kerbalized Soyuz mod, which is being made by forum user Derry Lee. And what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is, well, pretty self-explanatory there. It's right in the name. It's a Kerbalized Soyuz, which is pretty awesome. So let's jump right on into the vehicle assembly building and have a look at what all this does add in. So let's grab ourselves a Mark I command pod for size comparison's sake, and then head down to the janitor's closet mod filter, leaving on soy mousse and soy stock. And we'll start here in the command pod section with our two lovely command pods. The first being the artichoke command pod, which is, you know, sort of that typical Soyuz command pod there. And it is a pretty nice looking thing, very nicely modeled and textured. And being a mod, which right in the name says Kerbalized, I think it did a very, very good job with this and the texturing on all the other parts for that very end, which I do enjoy. Now, as for the stats on this thing, it does hold a maximum of 3 crew members, minimum of 1 crew member to operate, has a built-in data transmitter, a small little solid rocket booster with 15 kilonewtons of max thrust. It is a lifting surface, has a built-in reaction wheel, crew report, 50 electric charge, 10 monopropellant, and of course, 2 solid fuel for that little solid rocket booster. We then have the Artaprobe robotic probe, which of course is an unmanned command pod here, having a data transmitter, a reaction wheel, SAS, and 100 electric charge. A very nice looking little thing, and all in all, just a cool part. So let's actually head down into the fuel tanks category here and zoom out a bit, because, well, we got a few. The first one, of course, being the first R radial fuel tank with 1,004 liquid fuel and 1,232 oxidizer. And it is a pretty nice fuel tank here, zooming out a little bit more. And for this and all the other fuel tanks, we have 2 different texture variants, either the standard white or a gray and orange, which, frankly, is mostly gray, as you can obviously see here. And then we have the next part, the 2ST step-down adapter with 90 liquid fuel and 110 oxidizer, which we can pop on right there. We then have the 2ST step-down adapter, another size variant there with 90 liquid fuel and 110 oxidizer. We then have the 2ST 2-meter fuel tank with 180 liquid fuel and 220 oxidizer, and is, you know, a nice little tank there. We then have the 4-meter length variant of the 2ST right there, basically a double-sized version of the last one, and having 360 liquid fuel and 440 oxidizer. We then have the 2ST LT fuel tank with 504 liquid fuel and 616 oxidizer. The 2ST UT fuel tank with 720 liquid fuel and 880 oxidizer. Lovely thing there. And finally, the 3ST U potato fuel tank with 720 liquid fuel and 880 oxidizer. All in all, some lovely fuel tanks for you to use, and quite nice actually with both their capacity and looks. Good for any rocket you could build. We then have the engines. Let's actually zoom back in here for this, and the first one is the egg cup service module, which we can pop right onto there, and again, another beautiful looking part. And this one has a built-in alternator, an engine producing 100 kilonewtons of thrust in vacuum with an engine ISP of 345 in vacuum using liquid fuel and oxidizer. Does have a 4.5 degree gimbling range, built-in RCS, 180 liquid fuel, 150 oxidizer, or monopropellant rather, and then 220 oxidizer. I was getting ahead of myself there. And then for the next part, we have the RD-107 Habanero Pepper liquid fuel engine. Another beautiful looking thing there. I do like the detailing on it. And this one, again, has a built-in alternator, an engine producing 50 kilonewtons of thrust max in vacuum, 320 on the ISP, liquid fuel and oxidizer, but can be, throttled up a bit to having 350 kilonewtons of thrust with 320 ISP, and then, of course, has gimballing of 10 degrees. So very good, and having the sort of two-stage engine there, very nice. We then have the RD-108 Chili Pepper liquid fuel engine, again with sort of two power stages. We'll actually have to take that one off, as these two do not have an attachment point on the bottom, as they are sort of your final stage engines, or, well, rather, really the first stage you're going to get let off, I guess. And again, built-in alternator, 50 kilonewtons on one, 350 on the other, and again 320 on the ISP for both zones, and 10 degrees of a gimballing range. Very nice engine all in all. We then have the RD-124 Bell Pepper, which is a very lovely engine, I think probably my favorite of these, as it actually has two size variants. If we just right click, we can have either the basic configuration or a 2.5 meter configuration, which just makes the scaffolding up here a little bit bigger to fit your 2.5 meter bodies, which is quite nice. Now the stats on this thing, again, of course, built-in alternator, 200 kilonewtons of thrust max in vacuum with 350 ISP, liquid fuel and oxidizer, of course, and 2 degrees of gimballing for control. A very, very nice engine. Now, in command and control, we have nothing. In structural, we have nothing. But in coupling, we got a couple of things. The first is the ALVFD peanut fairing decoupler, which is a nice size little decoupler there, allowing, of course, fairings for the engines. We then have the ALVSD seed splitter decoupler, a nice structural looking one with scaffolding there I do quite like. And then the artichoke decoupler, a smaller variant there. And then finally, the bean sprout docking port, which, of course, you know, fits nicely right up there and goes together quite nicely. Now, in payload, we actually do have the peanut fairing, which we can pop on there and use as, like, any fairing, frankly. And it's just, again, a nice design variant. Aerodynamics, we got nothing. Ground, nothing. Thermal, though, we do actually have the artichoke heat shield, which goes on quite nicely, of course, to the artichoke pod here, and is, you know, just a pretty standard, nice little heat shield. In electrical, we do have the runner bean 1x4 solar panel, which is a lovely little thing. There we go, extended out, and just another nice addition. And I do very much enjoy the angled design to it there to fit flush with the rounded rocket. Always good. In communication, we do have the partially deployable antenna, which is a very small little antenna, which of course extends, and there you go. In science, though, we have nothing, and finally, in utility, we have three parts. The first being the broccoli chute and decoupler, which fits between either the robotic stage here or the artichoke command pod, and one of these service modules, or orbital modules, rather. So you have the broccoli chute and decoupler, which will, of course, decouple your main command module from your orbital module, and then deploy a parachute. And then we have the two orbital modules, this one being a crewed one, which can hold three Kerbals and do a crew report, and the second being the sprout module here, which can hold ore, a total of 400 if you do want to bring some back. And yes, that is all of the parts for the Kerbalized Soyuz mod. A very lovely selection of parts that I quite like. Not only is it cool to have more Soyuz things in the game, as it is always enjoyable, but we also, you know, have more Kerbalized parts, which is always good. And so let's actually load up a ship here, which I built earlier with all the parts, and no, not now. Now, these were actually the ship files, or craft files, rather, that came with the mod, and I had trouble getting them in. They need, apparently, something else to fly, but I just went ahead and made my own. Probably not well-built Soyuz here, which, you know, does the job. I built it in a couple of minutes, so it has a, spinning problem, which if I spent more time on, I could probably fix. But let's actually go to crew so we can check out the orbital module there. We, of course, have a, you know, the artichoke command pod and then the standard sprout orbital module for us to play with. And so let's go right out to the launch pad and take a look at this rocket in action. Well, or as well as we can, considering the fact, like I said, it kind of spins awkwardly. But that's just my own poor building. So yes, there we are, a lovely little Soyuz rocket ready to go and take our Kerbals into space. I do very much like all the parts. I think they are a lovely little addition. So let's turn back on our UI, throttle up, and actually, before we launch, let's take a look at the interiors. With the interior, of course, first of our main command pod, a very nice design. We, of course, do have IVAs for both this and the orbital module, and a very nice interior. I do love everything. They have a packed lunch there on the left-hand side, always good, and, you know, nice and spacious for our Kerbals. And, of course, from this side and this side, all in all, a very, very cool interior. And then we have the orbital module with just the one Kerbal inside. Again, nice and spacious, all the controls we need, and just a good, lovely little interior. So there we go. That is the internal view. Let's launch. There we are. And there goes the spinning. Seriously, I probably should have spent a couple of more minutes on building it, but that's kind of my thing at this point. I make a half-assed rocket to show off these parts, just to give you guys an idea. That probably would have helped if I actually put some struts there to hold those rockets down, but we're not gonna have them going forever, because, well, we need to see more things. Let's drop off that. Start up this lovely engine here. Again, I think my favorite of all the engines. It's a very, very nice design. And we're falling, so let's just go ahead and cut that engine. Fire! Fire that engine on our lovely little service module. Oh boy, we may need to deploy the parachute quick. And fire the rockets to slow us. And fire the parachute. There we go. A not successful launch in the slightest, but it showed off all the parts as we went, but that is the Kerbalized Soyuz mod. A lovely set of parts, which frankly I think is a great addition to the game, whether you are going to try and make your own Soyuz or, you know, just use all the lovely rocket parts for your own builds. It's just a nice set of things. So if you'd like to check it out for yourself, which I would definitely recommend you go and do, you can have a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that's going to be it for today, my friends. I hope you all have enjoyed and that you do come back for the next. But until that time, thank you for watching. And as always, have a good one. Now I'm going to extend these solar panels for no reason in particular whatsoever. Later, folks.